Boom. We are back on YouTube. Hope you guys are stoked for the return. I know I am. But anyways, I'm currently on my way to Grand Rapids, Michigan to get a training session in with Aaron Gumpert, who is the assistant strength and conditioning coach for Davenport University. So for all my dogs who are athletes over at Davenport, you know who I'm talking about. And we're actually training at the head strength coach's house, which is awesome. I'll get to meet him. Super stoked to collab with these guys, man. Aaron and me actually used to work together about a year ago, and then he got the opportunity to become the assistant coach over at Davenport. Let me tell you, man, I dedicate a lot of my knowledge now to that man, and just being able to have a mentor like that early on in my career was huge for me. And it's so awesome that I have these connections. I'm able to go out, train with these guys, gain knowledge. Anyways, man, I'm super stoked to be back on YouTube. I've been busy with some really great things. Been knee deep with online coaching. Obviously, the quarantine doesn't really help with anything. I'm not really going to dive into that subject, though. We all know this is a weird time in our lives, and we're all doing our best to deal with it. So I'll just say that. I know I'm doing my best to deal with it, keeping myself occupied, obviously. Hope you guys are doing the same. Just super excited for this training session. Every time me and Aaron train, it's an absolute grind. We're literally dead at the end of every session. And just the energy and the atmosphere is just second to none, and I absolutely love it. So I'm excited to take you guys through that. And then we're gonna dive into more knowledgeable stuff. So coaching, programming, maybe diet, and then other sort of stuff, and I'll talk to you guys when we get. Reactivation, chin curls, bridge, bell squat, that rope. Good old Aaron warm up.
Oh, yeah.
This is the way to do it.
Well, we do pre-activation all the time.
Oh, yeah.
For even our athletes at Davenport.
So let's see. We could do, because we ultimately. So for just the deadlift, I would say ISO, towel, and speed.
Yeah, because deadlift variations.
I would say barbell.
Yeah. So we can start with the ISO towel and then work up.
So I'm working, like, basically this would be the progression.
You want the barbell first or you want the towel first?
What's that?
You want to do towel first?
I would actually say towel first. Because okay. That's going to be the simplest thing. Because if nobody has any weights in it around, they fucking got a towel.
Right.
And isometric's really one of the best contractions to recruit more units and yeah. Get performance seems to increase. So
I know if you want to do barbell towel first, like start with the ideal of it.
We can show it with the barbell. We can show with a stick. We can show with a pipe. We can show with anything. Yeah. It's basically locking something in. No movement.
So ISO speed deficit, you know, on object.
Barbell time.
Put it all that together.
Time is going to be the intensity. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because off this, then you can build all the power series, which would be like box jump, which would be sprints, which would be all that different stuff.
Which that's a different part of it.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right now we're just getting the foundation straight.
This is gonna be epic.
It's the foundation.
The foundation. I never do Olympic lifts, so I'm a student today.
I've tried everything, baking soda.
Yeah!
good.
Today we're learning lat, but we're also learning that Gabe's not that strong in perspective here, okay? When we're working out with these animals.
Get the camera around, let me tell us something.
I got you.
The way we train, we train smart and hard. I've been doing this since 1994 without one injury in the gym. And I've been able to put up all kinds of volume, all kinds of intensity, but I know my body, and I train progression, and I follow the overload. That's the one thing, always making sure my body's in proper position, proper posture, and I'm working on all the intrinsic stabilizers, the secondary muscle groups to make you strong.
100%.
Train hard. My strength foundation, guess what? I'm not gonna be able to take hits. I'm not gonna be able to have fatigue throwing major power shots.
Exactly.
Throughout 4 to 12 rounds, depending on where they're at in the level. So like, you have to train through the balance. That's why undulating, again, works for all combat sports, for all, I believe, levels of sport,
besides,
you know, endurance athletes. But
I mean, it's just like anything. If you're a boxer that can only bench press 65 pounds, how hard is your punch versus someone who can bench press?
Ask fucking Mike Tyson. He's fucking 53 years old, still freaking.
Still getting after it.
Those combos, he's insane.
Those are deadly.
Those are deadly, man.
Everywhere, freaks and herons, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich, feed the poor, till they are never rich no more.
Oh,
Now we're getting creative here. So I'm gonna hit this for a set of 20 real quick. I'm kidding.
This one?
No. Let's go, Caleb, come on. Let's work.
Go!
Woo! Big weight, baby.
Come on. Oh yeah, great set, good.
Oh yeah, there we
that's
go.
That's smooth, up. Good.
There we go, come on.
He's out, there it is, good. Keep that tension. Up.
Rawr.
Let's go.
Nope.
Come on. Rawr.
Oh yeah, you definitely lost some tension there.
My glutes. Like this. Now,
fuck.
No, you need to work here, dude.
Okay. I felt those last reps, I was not getting any cool.
So like, if I go like this, if I squat, let's say you're ready to squat. If I'm up to Grummet, and I can feel this pressure here.
Uh-huh.
Like, if I'm here, I can feel that upper ab pressure. I'm like, oh, he's loaded, he's ready to go. You, I can put my hands here and push, and this was soft, there was no air. All you were doing was flexing your abs, but there was no diaphragm pressure, allowing that chest to stay elevated out of the hole.
All right, anyway, so what we're gonna do, we obviously have our tire here. We're gonna have three people active in this. So what you're gonna do is one person flips, then the other two are resting, one flip, then next man goes.
Okay.
Alternate through that for 10 minutes.
Fuck.
Try to get as many rounds as the team in together in that 10 minutes. This tire's estimated probably, it's not even that heavy, at least according to Grummet. So, 10 minutes won't be bad at all.
No.
See, I told you guys, this is what I get myself into. All right, but we gotta get better. So his tire flips weren't as bad as we thought.
No, we gotta do it again.
Got about, yeah, for real.
We gotta do it 20 minutes this time.
Yep. So we went from here all the way down to the field and back. That's one round, we got three of those. And apparently we're doing more, so. We moved quick though. We moved quick, that was good.
Yeah. That's almost there, dude. You're almost there.
You can just don't push yourself.
That's 315 pounds, dude.
That's 315?
Yeah, it's about 315,
but
it's like 300.
We're gonna
feel this.
Oh no, can't do it without dead behind you, huh?
So what's going to go first?
How far are we going?
Back?
I was thinking so.
And the next guy goes?
Yeah.
Okay.
How far are you going?
Down and back.
Like to the field?
Right?
Yeah.
Y'all are back here.
Okay. Do your stretches over there.
Oh, wow. It's going to be brutal.
Alrighty, so we went through barbell squats, tire flips, and then we had yoke carries, and now we're on to some supersets with flat bench, and then bent over rows here at the rack. How are you feeling?
Great.
So as you guys can see here, this bench is lower to the ground. Alright, so in a sense, that means less glute activation and heel drive. So basically, like Aaron was saying, I'll have him explain more kind of in depth, but we're gonna see how this translates onto a regular bench press when the gyms open up, when we actually can get that glute engagement and heel drive.
So like Abe was talking about, look, if you're competing with powerlifting or use leg drive at all on the bench press, the main thing is we look at so much of driving back our traps into the bench when we drive for that extension, gives us a little more leverage. With this, you don't get much leg drive. We can still try to contract our upper back. Of course, keep that back always tight for stability in the shoulders. But on the way down, and that push up, you're not gonna have that drive like you normally do. So yes, it's harder, but you can't let that destroy you ego-wise, because that's gonna transfer over better when you go into the gym again and you go for a regular bench press. You're gonna feel stronger off the chest. Guarantee it.
Why the fuck would we want harder? Is the overload, and that's what we gotta keep fighting for. Overload,
exactly,
baby.
Don't
feel good, what do you mean?
Yup.
All right, wait, wait, wait. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's easy. Stop playing with it. Come on. There we go.
Oh, yeah. Charted territories, and that's the human body.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody is so different, and there's different anomalies out there. I mean, like Steve Prefontaine was like, he could work through his lactic acid buildup like no one else.
Right.
You know, so
the average person probably can do that.
And so, like, when you're looking at scientific data and scientific testing on this individual, it's going to be off the charts. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you just got to be able to understand, like you said, knowledge, applying it, and incorporating what you're getting from your athlete.
Right.
Knowing when to pull back, knowing when to apply.
Mm-hmm.
But